When I was in college, streaming platforms hadn't yet begun to offer high-quality, lossless audio. And because of this, I would carry around a big case of CDs in my car to ensure I was listening to the music I loved as it was originally intended, free of the negative impacts of data compression algorithms. It wasn't until my sophomore year that my professor would help me understand that the CDs I had, while technically very high quality, were further from the sound of the original record than I thought. In this video, we're looking at what I believe to be one of the biggest reasons people subscribe to the idea that vinyl is better than digital formats, even though the reason has nothing to do with the delivery medium itself. What I want to focus on in this video isn't related to the technical capabilities of the playback format. I want to focus on something that makes a much bigger difference. In college, we had a class called Audio Aesthetics, where we would bring in songs to play for the class and discuss the audio techniques used in the recording. One day, I brought in a copy of Thriller by Michael Jackson on CD. This is one of my favorite albums to this day from a production perspective. After playing a track from that album, my professor opened up his even bigger case of CDs, pulled out a more weathered Thriller CD, and loaded it into the player. And somehow, this version sounded different. My professor explained that the version I had played was a remastered version, while the version he played was the original 1982 release. The playback medium was the same, CD. Both CDs provided 16-bit, 44.1 kHz, uncompressed PCM audio, but the content encoded onto each CD was not the same. The 1982 CD had a more open and dynamic sound, while the remaster sounded louder and more modern. To demonstrate this for you, I've got three versions of the Thriller album: the 1982 vinyl, the 1982 CD, and the 2001 CD remaster. I wish I could play these for you under educational fair use, but I don't think YouTube would be very happy with that. So we're going to stick to visuals in this video in the hopes that you can do some exploration later on your own. Input level calibration when recording vinyl is tricky, as I found out. So let's ignore the vinyl waveform and focus on the two CD waveforms. We can immediately see that the waveform for the 2001 remaster looks thicker, suggesting it's louder. The chorus looks and sounds considerably louder in the remaster, which isn't necessarily bad, just different. I place a lot of value on the idea of hearing what the original mixing and mastering engineers intended. So for me, this deviation from that original intention is not a good thing. Not because it's louder, but because it's different. This is a common phenomenon that can be found with many albums across various releases. And getting back to the point of the video, I think many people ascribe this difference in sound to the playback medium rather than the production process that preceded the release. The reason your CD sounds more compressed than the original vinyl isn't because it's a CD. It's because there are two different versions of the same song, although the differences may be subtle. CD and lossless streaming are fully capable of facilitating dynamic, full-range audio with very little noise or distortion. The idea of remastering a mix is not inherently problematic. The problem, as I see it, is that you can only buy the original release from a collector or a niche store. If you buy a new CD from a store or stream a song on Spotify, you'll be hearing the latest reissue in most cases. I don't know of a streaming platform that allows you to choose the version you want to listen to, and I think that's a real shame. I was just talking to a friend about this reality and how it's eroding our collective memory of what these classic albums sounded like, which I believe only pushes us further into this feudal loudness war that should be, but is far from, over. In the next video, it's on your screen now, we'll take a closer look at the technical differences between analog and digital formats. I'll see you there.